It's an honor and huge privilege for me to share the address of the first president of Kazakhstan, Nursultan Nazarbayev, dedicated to the participants of this remarkable event and who devoted significant part of his political career to the idea of achieving a nuclear weapons-free world. Let me now read out the address, and I quote. First of all, I would like to pay a tribute to the personal efforts of Mr. Antonio Guterres aimed at ensuring the central role of the United Nations in maintaining international peace and security in current challenging times. It's obvious that the coronavirus pandemic has plunged our entire planet into the grip of the so-called perfect storm. At the same time, we are well aware that humanity throughout its history has faced more serious challenges. Having personally overcome this virus myself, I am absolutely certain that we will successfully pass this global stress test, and that as a result, our world will emerge victorious from this struggle. Ladies and gentlemen, I am grateful to the organizers of our meeting today for their special attention to the International Day Against Nuclear Tests. I am proud that this day was established by the UN General Assembly in 2009 at the initiative of Kazakhstan and is now observed annually all over the world. On 29 August 1991, the Semipalatinsk nuclear test site, one of the largest on Earth, was closed following my decree. This decision to legally ban nuclear testing was the first in the history of humankind. Following Kazakhstan's first step, other test sites in various parts of the world also has become silent. Thus, my country's resolute step was supported throughout the world and paved the way for the comprehensive nuclear test ban treaty. In this context, we welcome the tireless work of Dr. Lasina Zerbo to promote and systematically implement the treaty. I am grateful that he has offered me a new, unique status of the CTPT champion. I consider it as an honor to accept this offer and would like to assure that I will devote all my energy and knowledge to the successful accomplishment of this new mission. Therefore, in my opinion, what should we pay attention to? First, we should be more persistent in convincing those countries that have not yet done so to sign and ratify the treaty and without any preconditions. Second, it's important to work out an initiative for the states on whose territory the test sites are located to eliminate the infrastructure of these facilities. Kazakhstan has all the necessary practical experience and is ready to share it. Dear friends, as the president of Kazakhstan for 30 years, I had deliberately devoted a significant part of my active foreign policy to the idea of achieving a world free of nuclear weapons. There were strong reasons for taking this stand. First, Kazakhstan has experienced all the horrors of nuclear explosions at the Semipalatinsk test site. For 40 years, 456 explosions were carried out on its territory, as a consequence of which 1.5 million of my fellow citizens have been severely impacted and suffered immeasurably. Second, having gained independence in 1991, Kazakhstan made a voluntary choice in favor of abandoning the world's fourth most powerful arsenal of nuclear weapons. History has affirmed the correctness of this step. With our own vividly tragic yet unmistakable example, we have shown that we can move on the path to progress and prosperity in a peaceful way. Third, I follow this idea based on my deep inner conviction that the future of humanity is dependent only on a world without nuclear weapons. Guided by this proven certitude, Kazakhstan became a party to all international treaties on nuclear disarmament and non-proliferation. As a mark of recognition of the merits and encourage the indefatigable striving of those who have united collectively in this noble objective, I have established the award for a nuclear weapon-free world and global security. The IAEA Low Enriched Uranium Bank, which has launched in Kazakhstan, plays a vital role in ensuring any state's legal right to develop atom energy for peaceful peoples under the auspices of the agency. In general, over these decades, Kazakhstan's diplomacy has invested extraordinary efforts to harness anti-nuclear strategies on international stage. The desire for nuclear weapon-free world has become the most important element in the national consciousness of the citizens of my country. Ladies and gentlemen, 75 years ago, nuclear weapons were used for the first time in world history, as a result of which Hiroshima and Nagasaki were practically wiped off the face of the earth. Several younger generations have grown up since this tragic destruction caused by the catastrophe, and so the horrors and consequences of nuclear tests are beginning to be forgotten. Today, the world is again on the edge of a deep abyss. We are all witnessing a geopolitical crisis in relations between the United States and Russia. The confrontation between Washington and Beijing is gaining momentum. A technological arm race is unfolding, including in outer space. We find a deliberate undermining of the legal foundations of the already fragile global regime of nuclear disarmament, non-proliferation, and peaceful use of atomic energy. Under these conditions, I would like to appeal to the international community to follow the example of Kazakhstan and join the efforts to finally end this nuclear madness. I believe that the leaders of the United States, Russia, China, and the European Union bear a special responsibility for the future of the planet. I am convinced that if a summit is held in this quadrilateral format, then one of these main themes should address the development of multilateral agreement on a phased and proportional reduction in nuclear weapons. Kazakhstan is ready to provide a platform for this summit. Ideally, if the UN could agree to assume leadership to organize and to conduct such negotiations in New York. Dear friends, I consider today's meeting as another opportunity to draw attention to the fact that a safe and peaceful future of our children and grandchildren can have genuine prospects only in a world without nuclear weapons. I am firmly convinced that sooner or later, planet Earth will get rid of this fatal weapon of mass destruction, and the main goal of my global manifesto, named the World 21st Century, will be achieved. End of quote. And I thank you for your attention.